invite the congregation to stand if that's comfortable for you.
Amazing grace. Oh, how sweet the sound that saved.
Welcome to this celebration of Lavonne Hanson and who she was and the promise of the resurrection that Christ holds for her. You are invited following the service over to the fellowship hall for a luncheon. The family will be going to the cemetery. If you're not going to the cemetery, you can go ahead and get lunch right away and the family will join upon their return. When you go out this way from the sanctuary, the restrooms are towards your left and the fellowship hall is straight ahead. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the source of all mercy and the God of all consolation. Christ comforts us in all our sorrows so that we can comfort others in their sorrows with the consolation we ourselves have received from God. Thanks be to God. When we were baptized in Christ Jesus, we were baptized into his death. We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death. So that as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. Eternal God, maker of heaven and earth, who formed us from the dust of the earth, who by your breath gave us life, we glorify you. We glorify you. Jesus Christ, the resurrection and the life, who suffered death for all humanity, who rose from the grave to open the way to eternal life, we praise you. We praise you. Holy Spirit, author and giver of life, the comforter of all who sorrow, our sure confidence and everlasting hope, we worship you. We worship you. To you, O blessed Trinity, be glory and honor forever and ever. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today your child and our loved one, Lavonne. We thank you for giving her to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see that death has been swallowed up in the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we may live in confidence and hope until by your call, we are gathered to our heavenly home in the company of all your saints, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. I invite the congregation to be seated, and at this time we'll hear our scripture readings.
Our first scripture reading that was chosen on this special day is Colossians chapter 3, beginning at verse 1. Paul writes, "Since then you have been raised with Christ. Set your hearts on things above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things above, not on earthly things. For you died, and your life is now hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory." Second reading is from Matthew chapter 11, beginning at verse 28. Jesus says, "Come to me, you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." And finally, from John chapter 14, beginning at verse 1, Jesus says, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in me. Believe also in God. My Father's house has many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you that I am going there to prepare." Let me start that over. "In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I am going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going." But Thomas the disciple said, "Lord, we don't know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus answered, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you really know me, you will know my Father as well. From now on, you do know him and you have seen him." Here ends the scriptures. Let's sing together another hymn, "Softly and Tenderly, Jesus is Calling." That's number 608 in the red hymnals, and in the front row, they're right below you in the rack.
Calling for you and for me. should we linger and heed not his mercies? Mercies for you and for me. Come home, come home. You who are weary, come home. Earnestly, tenderly, Jesus is calling, calling, oh sinner, come home. Oh, for the wonderful love he has promised, promised for you and for me. Though we have sinned, he has mercy and pardon, pardon for you and for me. Come home, come home. You who are weary, come home. Earnestly, tenderly, Jesus is calling, calling, oh sinner, come home.
Lavonne May Hanson, age 87, of Chatfield, passed away peacefully at Chosen Valley Care Center from pancreatic cancer. Lavonne May Harwood was born on September 20th, 1936, on the family farm in West Chatfield to Joseph and Martha Eck Harwood. She attended Chatfield schools and was a 1954 graduate of Chatfield High Schools. On June 3rd, 1955, she married her husband of 50 years, Morris Hanson. As a lifelong resident of Chatfield, Lavonne worked at several business locations, including, well, local businesses, Lynch's Grocery Store, The Pantry, The Silver Grill, Coast to Coast Hardware, and Hardware Hank. Lavonne was a people person and loved visiting with her customers. She was a member of Chatfield Lutheran Church since 1950, taught Sunday school, and was a member of the Women of the ELCA. Lavonne enjoyed car trips with her husband, trips to the casino to play her favorite slots, playing bingo, socializing with friends, and lunches at Mr. Pizza South. Lavonne loved Elvis and was an avid Vikings fan, often approaching strangers wearing Green Bay gear, telling them that they were wearing the wrong color. Lavonne is survived by her son, Rick Hanson of Ostrander, her daughter, Nancy and Tim Rislow of Lewiston, and one grandson, Wade Hanson of Rochester. She was preceded in death by her parents, her husband in 2006, an infant sister, and a sister, Joanne Harwood. May God bless the memory of our loved one, Lavonne. Well, grace and peace to you through our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ, especially to you, Nancy, and Tim, and Wade, and also, of course, son Rick. I want to show you two special gifts. This is the first gift. This gift was given to me by my best friend, Brett, who has a really interesting hobby, and that is stained glass window making. Now, this happens to be the same stained glass window that we saw together when we were traveling in the Holy Land. It's at a particular church in Nazareth. When he gave me this gift, I thought it was so very special. He said to me, well, it's not his best work, but to me, well, I know you spent hours doing it, and I know that it was made especially for me, and that made it pretty important. Says something about our relationship to one another. I want to show you another gift that's special to me, and this is this special stole that was given to me on my ordination date. I believe this kind of needlework is called hardanger, is that correct? I'm a German, so it all sounds French to me. But this has been with me for 32 and a half years, given to me by the women of the church where I grew up in Windom, Minnesota. So it's an all-purpose robe they consider it because it has all the different colors knitted, I should say needleworked, right into the fabric. Again, a special gift to me because I know the amount of time that went into it. And also when they were making it, they were thinking about me, this teenage kid who grew up in the church. I bring this up because things that are especially made are so important, right? I mean, the time that goes into things who give us something. I think about the Lord in Scripture. The God, too, is a knitter. He is a needleworker. God, too, is a he forms and he molds and he creates, all for a special purpose. I think about Genesis chapter 1, where it says that God created the earth piece by piece, and then ultimately human beings. After each day, God said those words, "Now this is good." God was proud and filled with love to make us and all of creation. I think about Psalm 139. It says that God knit us together in our mother's womb, intricately woven in the fabrics of the earth, wonderfully made. I think of a verse in Isaiah who says that God is the potter and we are the clay. In other words, he molds us and forms us. So many different ways in which God creates us, and after each creation, God is so wonderfully pleased with us. Ephesians chapter 1 said that God chose us before the foundation of the world with a purpose and a plan. Now, before the foundation of the world means that God was thinking about us for a long, long time. And all I can say is, wow, that's incredible what God does with the works of God's hands. And so now what can we say about each other today? And particularly this loved one of ours, this mother and grandmother and sister and friend, Lavonne. We can say that she is truly a gift of God to us. Now, her 87 years of life on this earth wasn't just a coincidence in the whole realm of time. Neither are any one of us a coincidence. You each have a specific purpose and a specific plan. Sometimes it takes us a long time to figure that out. But as we're trying to figure that out, wondering who we are, God has a smile on our faces, and since our God has a smile on his face, and since our baptism, God has been saying, "You are my daughter, and you are my son, and with you I am so well pleased." The look in her eyes, the sound of Lavonne's voice, the pleasure of her personality, we are all blessed in so many different ways because of Lavonne. So thoughtful and kind, she cared immensely about other people. She was outgoing and conversational with anyone that she met, whether it be at the Silver Grill or in the bingo room. I guess that conversation had to happen before or after bingo because she was pretty focused in between, right? She could talk for hours, whether she knew someone or not. She really never slowed down. I think her daughter Nancy would have to call and make an appointment if she wanted to see her at Lakewood. She truly made a difference in people's lives, not only at Lakewood, but everywhere else. Everywhere she went, she loved to travel with her husband, the obituary said, whether it be car trips to Arkansas, Branson, Las Vegas, or Hawaii. Everywhere she went, she made friends.
Why did you take a car trip to Hawaii?
Well, yes, that would be very difficult. Well, you know, back in those days, you'd get on a freighter and it would take you over, I think, right? No. And she loved animals, especially dogs. And so she loved to support Paws and Claws. And so she is making her home now in another place, A beautiful place especially prepared for her. Jesus spoke about that in John chapter 14 when he said, in my Father's house are many rooms. And each room is a special room prepared for each and every one of us. I just love the thought that God would describe heaven in a place that sounds safe for us. Most of us just love our own homes. You know, when we're away, we can't wait to get back home. And so God describes salvation, heaven, as a place where we can be at home and be blessed and be at peace and be filled with joy. Lavonne's hobby was cleaning, I've been told. Wow. She loved cleaning her house. Once a realtor visited her house and exclaimed, "This is the cleanest house I've ever seen." However, she might have to take up a new hobby in that heavenly house up there, because I would imagine when she arrived that that room was immaculately cleaned already, because God is really, really good at cleaning. Not only as we envision the wonder of salvation, but when Lavonne got to heaven's doors, she probably wondered, "Lord, I'm not sure if I'm clean enough to enter. I have sins in my soul. I've made so many mistakes. I've made so much trouble in my life. I'm so sinful." And the Lord says to her, "I'm the eternal cleaner, Lavonne, and you are saved by grace through faith. You are my child, and so today I tell you, well done, good and faithful servant. Not because you're good enough, Lavonne, but because I'm good enough. Each and every day I'm good enough for you." And so today we think about whether or not there is a bingo room up in heaven. Now, many people say there are all kinds of places to go and have fun up in heaven. I wonder if there's a bingo room. I suppose that there is. And it's free, though. You don't have to pay a thing. And the prizes that you get are eternal over and over and over again. So with the joy and peace she can experience in heaven, we give thanks. Today we place Lavonne into the loving and eternal arms of Almighty God. The family told me a particular incident when Lavonne was picked up by the police. Ooh, driving her fast Toyota, evidently. She loved her Toyota. Now, it took a while for her to pull over. The police had to follow her for quite a long time. When she finally did, the police officer asked, "Why didn't she pull over right away?" And she looked at him and said, "I did nothing wrong." You know, we do lots wrong in this world, and we have a Lord who loves us so much. John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him would not perish, but have eternal life." God is a self-giving, loving God who wants to renew us and restore us, to take his hands and make us like the gifts I showed to you that were special to me because it said something about my relationship with them. God gave us Lavonne, created and molded her to say, "I love her and I want to have a relationship with you through her." But now her time on this earth at least is done, and we place her into the loving arms of God. Where does that leave us? Well, first remember the Lord creates and recreates us. He molds us, he refines us. Do you remember the artist, the sculptor Michelangelo? One of the greatest Renaissance painters and sculptors ever. In talking about his sculpting, he would say that he never created his great works. Rather, he discovered them. Well, he said he uncovered them. Using his famous statue of David as an example, he said that God placed the art in the stone. And it was Michelangelo's job to bring out what God had created in that stone. So with the statue of David there, trying to see what was waiting to be uncovered, he was known to stand in front of the unfinished piece and yell out in frustration, "Come out! Come out!" And the Lord says that in purpose to us today. Come out and be the person I've created you to be. I love you so that you may love other people. I am a God that makes things on purpose, and I've made Lavonne. Now I want you to think about your lives and think about the purpose and joy you can bring into other people's lives. It all starts with Jesus Christ our Lord, who loves us, who died for us, who rose again, and prepares a place for you now in heaven. Amen. We sing our next hymn.
I invite the congregation to stand if it's comfortable for you. We are God's people through our baptism into Christ. Living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith through the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us join together in prayer. Almighty God, in holy baptism, you have knit your chosen people together into one communion of saints in the body of Christ. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. Lord, in your mercy, grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to share the new life in Christ. Lord, in your mercy, give courage and faith to all who mourn, and a sure and certain hope in your loving care, that casting all their sorrows on you, they may have strength for the days ahead. Lord, in your mercy, grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith that where this world groans in grief and pain, your Holy Spirit may lead us to bear witness to your light and life. Lord, in your mercy, help us, O God, in the midst of things we cannot understand, to believe and to trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to life everlasting. Lord, in your mercy. God of all grace, we give you thanks because by his death, our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed the power of death. And by his resurrection, Jesus opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, will be able to separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And now, gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray together as Jesus taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom,
and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Lavonne. Acknowledge, O God, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, and a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive Lavonne into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. And now, as we go forth in peace, we hear Elvis again.
There'll be no sadness,
no sorrow.